Greetings, students, and welcome back to another video on partial differential equations. In this lesson, I'm going to discuss the solution to the heat equation when there's an additional convection term, a term with a single partial derivative in x added to the mixture. Let me first take some time to describe the intuition behind this convection term. Suppose I have a rod that's perfectly insulated at the top and bottom and only allows the heat to propagate in the horizontal or x direction. I've already discussed the intuition behind the heat conduction term, the k times dy to u dy x squared term. So for this scenario, I'll initially pretend that there's no diffusion going on in the rod, only convection. Suppose I draw a graph of an example temperature distribution in this rod as a function of the position x along the rod. Now, what's convection? Well, convection is the transfer of heat as a result of the movement of a medium carrying thermal energy. In this case, if we have some medium like a fluid moving with a velocity of v down the rod, then heat transfer through convection will result from the movement of this fluid. Now let's say this fluid were moving to the right so that my v were positive. If I pick a point where the partial derivative of u with respect to x is positive, in other words, this graph is increasing, then fluid traveling towards this point in the rightward direction will be carrying thermal energy from an area of lower temperature to an area of higher temperature. And what happens to the high temperature area if the fluid from an area of low temperature travels towards it? Well, it cools down. So temperature at this point will tend to decrease as a function of time, which means that dy u dy t will be negative. But what if my fluid were traveling to the left? In that case, the medium's going from an area of high temperature to an area of lower temperature. So the area of lower temperature at this point will experience an increase in temperature. Let's now look at the opposite scenario and see what happens at a point where the partial of u with respect to x is negative, where the temperature is decreasing as we go down the rod. So somewhere over here, which I'll call point B. If my medium is traveling towards the right, so v is positive, it's carrying thermal energy from an area of higher temperature to an area of lower temperature. As a result, the temperature at this point B will tend to increase because it has warmer fluid coming towards it. The opposite applies if V were negative. Fluid traveling towards B will be carrying energy from a lower temperature to a higher temperature, so the temperature at B will tend to decrease. What can we conclude from all these scenarios about heat transfer by convection? Well, these scenarios show that the rate of change of temperature as a result of convection depends on two factors. One is the velocity of the medium carrying thermal energy, and the second is the temperature gradient at that point of interest. However, this dependence is negative because, as we demonstrated in our first scenario, if both V and dy u dy x are positive, then dy u dy t is negative. The temperature tends to decrease. Given all this intuition, we can write the rate of change of temperature from convection as the negative of V times dy u dy x. If we include heat conduction in the picture also, then the rate of change of u will be k times the partial of u with respect to x, the second partial of u, minus v times the first partial of u with respect to x. And this PDE is known as the heat equation with convection. Hopefully the intuition I gave for the convection term makes sense to you. Now for the rest of this video, I'm going to be solving the heat equation with convection for an infinite domain with an arbitrary initial condition. Note that there's no boundary conditions here because the domain is infinite. There are no boundaries. And because the domain is infinite, one way to solve this PDE is to use Fourier transforms, kind of like we did in our Fourier transforms video that came before this. But before that, we should try to make a change of variables in this PDE problem so it becomes something without the convection term. And we can actually do that. We let y equal to x minus vt, and we create another variable tau that's equal to just t. Now, in order to implement this change of variables, we need to take the second partial of u in x and the first partial of u in t, and write those in terms of the partial u partial y and partial u partial tau, so the partial of u with respect to the new variables. And if we take the partial derivatives of u with this change of variables in mind, we'll find that the partial of u with respect to t is the partial of u with respect to y times dy y dy t plus the partial of u with respect to tau times dy tau dy t. And this is just straight up from the chain rule. If we then plug in the values of dy y dy t and dy tau dy t based on the equations that we initially used to define them, this is what we will have. We can also take the partial of u with respect to x, in which case this is what we'll end up with, again, based on the chain rule. Now, the partial of y with respect to x is just 1, and the partial of tau with respect to x is 0 because tau only depends on t. It doesn't have any x term within its definition at all. So my partial of u with respect to x equals the partial of u with respect to y. So naturally, if we find the second partial of u with respect to x in terms of the partials of u with respect to y and tau, then by the chain rule, we'll find that the second partial of u with respect to x is exactly equal to the second partial of u with respect to y. If we now plug this into our PDE problem, this is what we end up with in terms of the new variables y and tau. The first partials with respect to y cancel on both sides, and the initial condition would correspond to a tau of 0, so phi of x would just become phi of y. Since at tau equals 0, t is 0, and when t is 0, y equals x minus vt would just become y equals x. So at this stage, we've now got a simple heat equation on an infinite domain with one initial condition. And this is exactly what we solved in our previous video on Fourier transforms. The solution is given by the following equation. I'm not going to do the whole solution because I already have done it in the previous video. And this solution represents the convolution of the initial condition and this exponential function, which is basically the Green's function, the temperature distribution if my input, if my initial condition, were a delta function or an impulse. Note that this y tilde is now the dummy variable I'm integrating over. And again, since I've derived this solution in my previous video, I won't do it again over here. And finally, if I replace my y with x minus vt and tau by t, this is the solution to my heat equation with convection for an infinite spatial domain and arbitrary initial condition. And this is your full solution. All you had to do was make a change of variables, and with that you'd be able to convert the heat equation with convection to a regular heat equation. And in general, this is the change of variables that you would use to solve a heat equation with convection. Anyway, that should do it for the lesson. I'd like to thank the following patrons for supporting me at the $5 level or higher, and if you enjoyed the video, feel free to like and subscribe. This is the Faculty of Khan, signing out.